assists local law enforcement agencies in the fight against crime by providing anonymous, vital information that could lead to arrests.
And that tip could earn you a $1,000 reward. Let's bring him in. It's the Sarge in Charge.
All right. All right, the Sergeant Charge is here. Sergeant Chris Kim, how you, bro?
Good.
Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
We always love him coming in and talking story with us.
We do, and he's so, like, you know, just kind of laid back until we get into the cases, then that's when the Sergeant Charge is activated.
You'll
over
get
here.
Get all nuts after that.
All right, Sarge, case number one, we got a bullet head baddie over here. Now, this guy left the store without payment. What's the scoop? What's the deal with this guy?
Yeah, so this is actually a shoplifting that happened over at the Pearl Ridge on Monday, July 22nd, 2024, at about 4:30 p.m. This guy walked into a retail establishment at Pearl Ridge, basically grabbed a whole bunch of clothing items, then proceeded to exit the store without making payment, but loss prevention officers met him outside, at which point he got startled, dropped everything, and he dug out. But, you know, regardless, it still classifies the theft in the second degree. He's been described as an unknown man in his 40s, approximately 6 feet to 6 feet 2 inches tall, wearing white shirt and black pants.
Big guy, as we mentioned, on bullethead guy, so, you know, if you got any leads on this, please let the Sergeant Charge know and his team from Crime Stoppers Honolulu.
Absolutely. Now, the next case involves a group who used a garage door opener to pull off their burglary. Tell us all about this IAL home burglary.
Yeah, so this case on Wednesday, July 24, 2024, about 4:17 a.m., these three individuals entered a vehicle that was actually left unlocked in front of the complainant's home. They then took the garage clicker and started clicking on it, and as soon as that garage door opened, they proceeded to enter and take numerous property. The video isn't the greatest, but we're using this as a learning tool to kind of let people know that please always lock and secure your vehicles, and be very mindful as to where you're placing your garage clickers. If you're able to conceal it, hide it, or whatever you need to do. But first and foremost, once again, always lock and secure your doors.
Yeah.
You know, Sarge, we have talked about this in the past where it's important, even though you feel safe in home, on your own property, it's still important to make sure that all of your property is locked up.
Yeah, time and time again, we've had cases like this where we're constantly reminding the public, you know, even though your car is in the garage, in the carport, even in front of your house, always lock and secure your doors, because we do have people roaming the neighborhoods while you're fast asleep, just pulling on the door handles and hoping to get lucky.
You know, we're watching that video. It was almost like they knew where to park. Maybe they knew where the cameras were. You see, like, they knew exactly to park right behind that tree and then get out and then go looking for that garage door.
Yeah, opener. These definitely aren't amateurs. You know, these people, they're very smart in what they do. They canvass the neighborhood. Oftentimes, they're able to visibly see the security cameras, and so they park in a certain way where it's going to be obscured.
Yeah.
Now, all right, Sarge, this last case is very disturbing because it involves violation of privacy. Please give us the details on this.
Yeah, so as far as this case, a violation of privacy in the second degree on Monday, July 29, 2024, at about 3:10 p.m., the complainant was using the bathroom in a hotel in the Waikiki area when this suspect allegedly stuck his cell phone camera underneath the divider, and the complainant, as he's sitting down doing his business, he sees the cell phone camera pointed towards him. He immediately exits and confronts this male, who then flees. He's been described as an unknown African-American male, possibly in his 30s, approximately 6 feet 2 inches tall. At some point, I guess the complainant was asking for his name, and he's saying that his name was Sid. I highly doubt his name is Sid, but regardless, we're asking for the viewers, if you know anything about any of these cases that we talked about, please contact the Crime Stoppers. All three cases we talked about today can be seen over at the www.honolulupd.org website, bottom left-hand corner, under Wanted Persons.
We also got the app, right?
Yeah, so please, if you have information and you don't want to call the hotline, download the P3 Tips app available on your smartphone or tablet. Either way, we keep you 100% anonymous, and you'll be eligible for up to $1,000.
Right on. The Sergeant Charge of it. You know, every time you come on, the ratings go like this. So
for real.
That's why we love having you on, bro. Come back anytime.
Thank you.
But thank you so much for helping keep our community safe. We
appreciate
you.
As always, thank you so much right as well.